All right, haven't been using the range much for a while, and you can tell, but I'm gonna do a couple of things today to reinforce the practice that we did on Sunday. So hopefully we'll have a little bit of fun here. Try to keep that down as low as possible. This is my carry gun. It's a Glock 19, and trigger has polished internals and a Apex Tactical shoe, just because I like that flat shoe a lot better. I hate the ribbed trigger that comes on these. Pretty much stock though, as far as the characteristics of the trigger, it's just a little smoother. About a 6 pound, 5.5, 6 pound pull weight. I've got Trigicon XR sights. They're the Trigicon HDs, but this newer version, the XR, it is has a slightly thinner front sight. It's the only difference. I like that. It's still not a thin front sight, but with this U-notch, I like the U-notch a lot better than the Ameriglows. So what we're going to do is, I guess, reinforce some of the things that we worked on in practice, where we're talking about this snap trigger press. So you can do this in dry fire, but when you practice it on the range, we're going to stand back at about 5 yards. I just want to use that smallest little circle to see where my sights are. So perfect sight alignment, top edges of the front and rear, equal light on both sides, and that top edge of that front sight, that top edge is going to split that little spot. I'm going to come in contact with the trigger, and then I'm just going to snap through to the rear when I see it cross. Okay, so I'm on. I'm not sure how much of that was me or the sights being off, but that is way smaller than a dime. You can see it's just the tip of my pinky finger size dot. But as you see, you can get a snap trigger press, a very quick trigger press. Let me shoot that steel one time. That's a 4-inch wide steel. 4-inch wide steel. Let me go back to about 15 yards, because that would mean 8-inch steel at 30 yards. That's a pretty good challenge. And I'm gonna see how good my trigger press is. So I'm not gonna enter this trigger guard, not gonna enter it with my finger until I'm on target. I don't wanna launch one over the berm or do something stupid. So I'm gonna start the timer and wait for it. During that time, I'm gonna get in on the target and prep the trigger. That means I'm going to come in contact with the trigger and take up the slack. I'm not going to begin pressing the shot. I'm just going to take up the slack, prep the trigger, whatever that means on your gun. But when I hear that timer, I want a reaction speed trigger press. Okay, hit the center of the steel. See what that time is. Ah, well, 19. It's just hard to hold the sights on that small target. Okay, that's another one, 18. So human reaction time average is about 0.25. So I'm actually hearing the beep, reacting to it. So there's no time to think here. I've already made the decision to shoot. I'm just reacting. All right, so I'm see where I stretched that hole a little, but look, 19. So that tells me my trigger press is good. I have a trigger press that support is coming straight back. It's a snap trigger press, and my fundamentals are absolutely rock solid. So what we'll do is we'll have a little fun here. I'm gonna shoot a casino drill, but this is 6, 7, and 8 in the mag. I'm just gonna shuffle these up, put two of them on my belt, and put one in the gun. I'm concealed carry inside the waistband. I'm going to stand at 5 yards and going to run one shot on one, two on two, three on three, four on four, all the way up to 6 shots on 6. Now, realize that triangle is half the area space, the square inches, half of that 3. Okay. And this is how you run it. You just draw. You've got a draw stroke. You've got those 21 shots, and there are going to be 2 reloads pop up in the middle. Main goal of this drill is to have your use of the tools, your fundamentals, your gun handling, manipulation, and shooting down pat, so that it's more of a subconscious skill and you're able to think about colors and numbers and counts and things like that, as that's what you're focused on, not the shooting. If you haven't trained hard enough to have that basic skill, you'll fail the drill. 5 yards, here we go. 21 seconds, including the half point down penalties. If I get a slight miss and it's still on paper and still close to the target, I count that as a half a second added per shot. I don't really like to miss. Okay, here we go. Concealed carry, stand by. Okay, all I'm doing is just watching the sights, pressing the trigger. Zero down, all hits, 1355. That's about normal concealed carry with a Glock 19 for me. If I have a competition gun, it's somewhere under 11 seconds total. So that is the first version of a casino. You can run it with the mags being 777, 678, 789. You can run it where you're going in reverse from 6 to 1. Or 1 to 6, or 135, 246, you know, that type of thing. And they, with these targets, they have about 3 different versions. Tom Gibbons runs them with these targets most of the time. I really like the Lee Weems T by T targets, T space X space T. They're on gunfun.com. I like them because they have a bottle in the middle, and I can shoot parrot drills, I can shoot FBI, Rangemaster, quals, and the casino on that one single target. So our standard will be the gun fun target. So this is just a reinforcement of some of the things that we worked on in our last practice, and look forward to seeing you next time.